వందేహం శ్రీగురు శ్రీయుత పదకమలం.
It is the stage after self-realization at which the devotee becomes one with Krishna in the sense that Krishna becomes everything for the devotee. And the devotee becomes full and loving Krishna. An intimate relationship between the Lord and the devotee then exists. In that stage, there is no chance that the living entity will be annihilated. Nor is the personality of Godhead ever out of sight of the devotee.
How he can become out of sight? He sees everything in Krishna and Krishna in everything. Everything in Krishna and Krishna in everything. Then how can he lose sight of Krishna? Yeah.
To merge in Krishna is spiritual annihilation. A devotee takes no such risk. It is stated in the Brahma Samhita, I worship the primeval Lord, Govinda, who is always seen by the devotee, whose eyes are anointed with the pulp of love. He is seen in his eternal form, Shyam Sundar, situated within the heart of the devotee.
Shyam Sundar. This is Shyam Sundar. The Kartamasai. Samasam. Premanyana Surita Bhakti Vilochanena Santasadaivaridayesu Vilokayan. Yang Shyamasundaram Machinta Gunasarupam Govindam Adipurisham Tamang Bhajam. So one who has developed this love of Krishna, he sees Samasundar, the Kartamasai, always within his heart. That is perfection of it. Kattamasa, I have given that name, of course. He is Samsundar. Yes. All right. Then, next paragraph.
At this stage, Lord Krishna never disappears from the sight of the devotee, nor does the devotee ever lose sight of the Lord. In the case of a yogi who sees the Lord as Paramatma, within the heart, the same applies. Such a yogi turns into a pure devotee and cannot bear to live for a moment without seeing the Lord within himself.
Yes, sir. Okay, this is the process of seeing God. Otherwise, God is not my order supplier. Please come in and see. You have to learn. You have to qualify yourself. How to see God every moment, everywhere. And this simple qualification is simple. That's not very difficult.
The yogi who knows that I am, the Supersoul within all creatures are one, worships me, and remains always in me in all circumstances.
The purport is there. Go on.
A yogi who is practicing meditation on the super soul within himself sees this plenary portion of Krishna as Vishnu, with four hands holding conch shell, wheel, club, and lotus flower.
This picture, Vishnu picture, that is the objective of concentration for the yogi. That is real yoga. And this Vishnu manifestation is Krishna's plenary portion. In the Brahma Sanghita, it is said, Jakkarunarnavajale bhajatisma yoga nidramananta jagadanda saroma kupa sa Vishnu Mahan sa yajasa kala visesa Govindamadi purusam tamaham bhajam. I worship Govinda, the primal Lord, Govindam adi purusam. Purusam means the Lord is male, angel. Adi, the original. Govindam Adi Purusam Tamaham Bhajami. And who is that Govinda? Now, whose only one plenary portion is Mahavishnu. And what is the function of Mahavishnu? Jasaika nisyasita kala mathavalambra jivanti loma bilaja jagadannanatha. In every universe, there is a chief living entity who is known as Brahma. Brahma is the original person in each universe. So, the life of Brahma or the life of an universe is existing only on the breathing period of Mahavishnu. Mahavishnu is lying on the causal ocean, and while he is exhaling, millions of universes are coming as bubbles, and they are developing again. And when he is inhaling, millions of universes are going within him. So that is the position of this material world. It is coming out and again going in. Bhutya bhutya praliyate. In the Bhagavad Gita also it is said that these material universes are being created at a certain period and again become annihilated. Now this creation and annihilation is depending on the exhaling and inhaling of Mahavishnu. Just imagine what is the caliber of that Mahavishnu. But that Mahavishnu is said here, jasaika nisyasita kalamathavalamba jivanti loma vilaja jagadannanatha Vishnu mahan sahiya jasya kalavishesha. This Mahavishnu is plenary portion of the plenary portion of Krishna. Krishna is the original. Govindamadi purusanta mahamuja. So, this Mahavishnu again enters into each universe as Garbhodak Sai Vishnu. And from Garbhodak Sai Vishnu, there is Kirodak Sai Vishnu. That Kirodak Sai Vishnu is entering in the heart of every living entity. In this way, the Vishnu manifestation is all over the creation. So, the yogi's concentration of mind on this Vishnu form, that is explained. That Vishnu, who is all-pervading, who is Ishara Sarva Bhutanam Riddhesa Arjuna Tisthati. In the Bhagavad Gita you will find that Mahavishnu, that Kirodak Sai Vishnu is sitting in everyone's heart. Now yogi has to find out where he is sitting and concentrate his mind there. That is the yoga process. Wow. The yogi should know. Go on.
The yogi should know that Vishnu is not different from Krishna. Yes.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna. Hare